I would say my grandfather is the inspiration behind this. He was a police detective in Duluth, Minnesota, and he struggled with addiction his whole life. He was a beautiful man, but he had this substance abuse issue that he couldn't kick, and he went in and out of multiple recovery places, and he finally was able to recover after he went to a recovery place in California that was only about God and love. So instead of using discipline or I'm going to take this away, this place used love and God. And he was 67. And then he went on to be this voice for Duluth, Minnesota for AA, and his coming forward and saying that he had gone through this and how he overcame it through God and love was something that I thought, if there's a way to take the words of the Serenity Prayer that he shared with so many people and turn it into another avenue for people to hear, it might affect them more deeply if they read it or if they have a plaque. And then other people might remember it more, might be moved more. I thought if it's in a melodic form, because songs can stay in our head. And that was the inspiration for originally contacting Peter and Tom.
What was occurring in my own life in that town would have been back in 2010. And I suppose in 2005, my world began to change from what I had a very good American dream. I was living on a 30-acre farm and everything, and a wonderful wife and family. And after a car accident, everything completely changed. Everything went to hell in my life. I mean, I had a 30-acre farm. Like I said, I lost it. And I was became involved with the law, so I mean, I was looking at some serious time for trying to protect what I thought was my family and everything, and fighting for what my father told me was the most important thing in your life is your family, and that's exactly what I was doing. But I had an anger issue with it, and I was in a lot of trouble. Lori came into my life, Lori Morrison at the time, and through Pete Greenland, Peter introduced us, and met her, and she started giving me a ride in my probation meetings after I got out of jail, after we had our friendship evolved over a period of time. And I know that she was into lyrics and poetry, and I was a musician, so she asked if I'd be interested in putting music to that song. And that was probably 12 years ago.
So I started reading more about the Serenity Prayer, and I found out Reinhold, who is credited with the authorship, went to Princeton and Harvard, and he was a minister. And so these words weren't any accident. So I wanted to share not only what's common knowledge about the Serenity Prayer, but add some more of the words of what he wrote. The prayer is not in a melodic form, so it's very difficult to put it into a musical composition, which Tom did absolutely brilliantly. We spent hours and hours in each other's living rooms, and we have many initial CDs with different versions on them. We have a video of everyone playing in my living room. That's just something that I cherish. I don't know why we disband. But now that we have 10 more years of living and maturity and wisdom under our own belts, so now, well, as we're coming together, there's a whole different feel to this. So bringing everybody back, even Dustin Phillips, who is doing some of the production in Denver, he was on this. His hands were on this 10 years ago. I honestly feel as though Deja'Blu Dial was the missing piece, and her spirit, her joy, her energy is absolutely making this project and this song, I think, much more powerful. And so I'm very thankful that we didn't finish it over 10 years ago and that we're doing it now at this stage of our lives.
Who am I singing the Serenity Song to is my mother and family members that have lost their lives to addiction that nobody really gave them the courage.
The first three verses have worked in so many people's lives, you know. And I was a staunch fighter against the 12-step program all my life. I just did not believe in it. And they utilized that in the 12-step program. And it's the truth. I mean, it's you need the serenity to accept the things that you cannot change. And you're born with the courage. You just got to find it inside of you to change the things you can and the wisdom to know the difference. Because a lot of times you believe that you can't fight this, and then you're not really being wise about it because you fight everything. But if there's something that you can change and you're just giving up on it, then that's not using the wisdom and the courage that you have inside you to do it.
My family, my mom, she was on drugs and stuff. And she talked about serenity prayer, which they taught her when she was in prison and in drug rehab and stuff like that. And recently, my best friend and I, Antonia, we were saying the serenity prayer a lot last year up to this year. And just, I mean, all I can say is it's shocking. I really never thought that that would prepare me for the Serenity Song. Never.
A lot of the writings in scripture and other sacred texts are done in a melodic form to help people remember because they didn't have books back then. So I added the additional lyrics really to help turn it into a form of a song that could be played on the radio.
What do I hope occurs when people hear the prayer? I hope it affects them as much as it affected me, and I know millions of other people. That's all you can really ask, that if you just really, really truly listen to what the words are saying, you'll understand what it means. And I hope that just clicks with people and they can grasp it, because it makes life a lot more simpler just knowing that, you know?
When others hear this in melodic form, I want them to receive it from my heart to their heart. My heart to their heart. Hear what we're saying, hear the words that we're saying. Not only hear the words, but feel them in your heart. Let them touch your soul and help you to rivet that from the inside out of knowing that you're not by yourself with this. We want to encourage you and to hold on to it. Never let it go. Never let it go. That's how I want them to receive.
God grant me the serenity, accept the things that I cannot change. God grant me the courage to change the things that I can. And God grant me the wisdom, know the difference. Amen. Taken as it is, the sinful world as it is. everything's that I cannot change.
It's a loud whisper is what I call it. It's a godly whisper, and he puts them in front of you at periods of your time in your life, continuously, as long as you're alive. And this happens to be one of the moments where it's, I can just see everything that's going on, the people like Deja'Blu Dial, and she's come into my life and my buddy Joshua's life. Lori's back in here, Peter's back in here. You know, there's a bunch of people that are coming around, and it's just a godly thing that's happening at a time and a lot of people around me, their lives, that it's needed, and including mine. I mean, it's just, it's a great feeling to be able to hear this song, and after 12 years of hearing it, I was just blown away by it. And it's just coming out now, and I'm finding a peace in my life, huge, with nothing. I have probably less than I've ever had in my entire life, and I've never been so damn happy ever in my life. So it's just, it's a God thing. It really is.
I've been asked a few times where my name comes from, Deja'Blu Dial. There's a meaning to the last name, more so than the first name. And it's like Deja'Blu, one word. Dial comes from a teacher, a white teacher that was in back home. And they threatened because she wanted to adopt me due to going through struggles at home. She wanted to adopt me and take me home with her. And they threatened to take away her retirement, everything. She had been in teaching for years. I know about 30 years at that time. And she was gonna give that up for me. And I was like, I get a second chance, and to use her name is an honor. So Dial, Miss Barbara Dial, I hope you hear this. I hope you know your family. No, I love you. That's all I wanted to say. I never forgot her.
Well, God grant me the serenity, save the things that I cannot change. God grant me the courage to change the things that I can. And God grant me the wisdom to know the difference.